Hey everyone, today we are going to paint these beautiful sakura branch. To start with, I'm choosing the color. I'm using Bordeaux from my Shinhan Professional Watercolor Set. I'm planning to make the branch diagonally on the paper, so I'm seeing how to place the branch. I'm making a rough outline by drawing it, but if you're confident, you can go straight away to painting. Sakura are actually quite easy, so you don't need to draw it specifically, but it gives me a better picture on how the painting would look like and how I want my flowers to be placed. So if you feel the same, please go ahead and draw it. You can refer to the picture which is shown here. Let's start the painting now. So we'll take a really diluted pink on our brush. Make sure your brush is not too wet. Just tap it on a piece of paper or cloth so you remove the excess water, because these flowers are so small, if you have too much water on them they'll become blobs, so you don't want that. And continue this process of making small flowers. We are not defining too much, this is just the first wash, so we are just creating the petals. So one tip is make the branch in the end, because that way you can have some flowers behind the branch without too much effort, since the branch is a bit darker shade than the flowers themselves. So let's continue painting and making more flowers. Try to make flowers of different angles and different shapes. Make a few buds here and there and just enjoy the process. This doesn't have to be too defined, because sakuras are generally loose, easy 5-petal flowers, so you can just enjoy yourself when you're painting it. One more tip is to keep the paint within the pencil lines that you have drawn before. That way, in the end, when the paint dries up, you can erase the pencil marks easily. And since these flowers are very light in color, and if you paint over the pencil marks, you will not be able to erase it and it will show through the paint. After the first layer is dry, you can erase the pencil marks, but remember it should be dry, otherwise you're going to spoil your paper. Like I said before, make sure when you're painting the flowers are within the line, so it's easy to erase later. Now I'm painting the buds. For the buds, I'm using a darker value of the same color, and I'm just adding them using the reference picture, a few here and there. I'm not really sticking to the reference picture, but buds are like fillers, so you can just add them wherever you feel you want it to be more dense. Now let's start adding the second layer with more details. What I'm doing is taking a darker value of the same color on my brush. My brush is not too wet at this time. I've just dabbed it on the paper. I'll take the darker value and put it in the center of the flower. Then I will wash the brush and dab it again on the paper to remove the excess water. And I'll start pulling the paint to make the stamen and the pollen. So you have to be very gentle and light with this process. You're just pulling the paint with a wet brush, not a super wet brush, just the tip is slightly wet, and you're pulling the paint to create the stamen. So I think in this angle I'm hiding some of the detailing process with my fingers, but you can see on other flowers how I'll be doing it. So again, we just put some paint in the center and then pull the paint with the little red brush tip and continue this process for all the flowers. Just put some paint in the center and start pulling with a really light hand. We want the stamen to be really thin and delicate looking, so we don't want to press the brush too much. We are literally using just the slight tip of the brush to pull the paint. If you're finding this difficult, you can practice a little on another paper and then come and do it on the painting. Or if you have a detailing brush, then you can go ahead and use that here. Let's paint the branch now. We'll use red brown from the branch. This can also be used to create some details on the buds. When you're making the branch, you can also make it go over some of the flowers. That way it looks like the flower is behind the branch. I haven't done that in this painting, but you can do it now or later. It's up to you. And once you add the branch, you can also use the same color to add the stem and some more details to the buds and the flowers. So you can see I'm adding small stems to each of the flowers and to the buds. After adding the branch, I felt like I needed to add a few more flowers, so I'm just creating rough flowers to fill up the branch a bit. You don't have to be too specific, as I mentioned before. So have a look at the painting. Maybe what I do sometimes is click a picture, so somehow I understand better how the painting is looking instead of looking at the painting in real life. So once I saw the picture, I felt like the branch was looking empty, so I started adding a few more flowers to the branch. Don't have to be too stressed about where to add and what to add, just make a few petals here and there and the detailing will take care of the rest. Okay, now that we have the new flowers, I'll add some details to those flowers as well. I'm basically just adding the stems and I'll use the same red brown color to add the pollen to the stamens that I had painted earlier. And this is the step where you can add the pollen to even the flowers for which the center was not visible. So that way we can use the same pollen to pull the paint and create the stamen for those flowers. Again, make sure your hand is very light when you're doing this process. You don't want the pollen to be too overwhelming and too big. You just want delicate dots to be added at the end of the stamen to have the pollen effect. And whoops, the paper flew, so I should maybe pin the paper next time. But it's okay, it gives a good effect as well. Now I'm taking Van Dyke Brown, which is a darker shade of brown, to add more details to the branch. When you're painting the branch, the light is falling from the right side, sort of. So we'll keep the right a bit lighter than the left side of the branch. And use the same brown to even add some details to the parts from where the stem is coming out on the branch. So that gives a good detailing as well. And then we will use permanent yellow to add pollen to all the stamen that we had painted earlier. You don't have to be too specific about this. It just has to be lightly added randomly to the pollen. Not all of them should have it. It's just for a nice effect. And to finish the painting, we'll use a softer value or lighter value of the same red brown that we had used to add the details of the stems and the branch earlier. The sakura leaves are very soft and transparent looking, so you can use a lighter value of the red brown to create that effect. And you can also add some more details using a darker value of the red brown to create some veins to the leaves if you're interested. And that's all there is for this painting. I hope you enjoyed painting this beautiful cherry blossom branch with me. And don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel and follow me on Instagram for more paintings.